China is making biological weapons and testing it on Pakistanis, and its Wuhan lab and coronavirus scientists are deeply involved. A story that seems to have come straight out of a Frankenstein medical thriller novel is unfolding in flesh and blood in the country of Pakistan. According to a report in an Australian portal named The Klaxon, it has been revealed that Pakistan and China have entered a secret 3-year deal to expand potential biowarfare capabilities, including running several research projects related to the deadly agent anthrax. The report states that China, via its Wuhan Institute of Virology and its coronavirus scientists, is testing lethal biological agents in Pakistan since 2015 and also providing extensive training on the manipulation of pathogens and bioinformatics to the Pakistani scientists, which could enrich a potential offensive biological program. Wuhan lab scientists have been conducting extensive research operations on deadly animal to human pathogens in Pakistan, and the report mentions that so far the studies have involved over 7,000 Pakistani farmers, herders, and over 2,800 camels and other animals. China's Wuhan Institute of Virology has allegedly signed a secret 3-year deal with Pakistan military's Defense Science and Technology Organization, or the DESTO, to further collaborate on the development of the deadly pathogens. This is the same Wuhan Institute of Virology which is being attributed as the birthplace of novel coronavirus, or COVID-19, that has infected over 24 million people worldwide and has taken the lives of over 800,000 people. It is alleged that the program is involved in various dual-use research projects, which means those that can have both civilian and military applications. The studies involve experiments and genome sequencing of the West Nile virus, the MERS coronavirus, Crimean Congo hemorrhagic fever virus, the thrombocytopenia syndrome virus, and the chikungunya virus. There is no vaccine or cure for any of those pathogens, which are also considered as among the world's deadliest and most contagious viruses. The website, citing highly reliable and credible intelligence sources, said that the program is being entirely funded by China and is formally titled as the Collaboration for Emerging Infectious Diseases and Studies on Biological Control of Vector Transmitting Diseases. And there is fear of pathogens escaping the ill-equipped labs. The article in Klaxon further raised key concerns about the covert labs and their reliability and security by stating that the terrorist state of Pakistan could use the technology in biowarfare, or that deadly pathogens could accidentally escape from the inadequately equipped facilities. The secret project was detached from the supervision of civilian universities or government health departments in Pakistan and was structured to allow unspecified future operations. Beijing, through the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, or CPEC as it is known, has spread its tentacles deep inside Pakistan's territory and has made the country a dumping yard and a dilapidated laboratory to conduct its Frankenstein medical experiments. The Wuhan-Pakistan military tie-up had never been publicly announced or disclosed before, and it raises further suspicion on the covert operations going on in the terrorist state. In fact, Pakistan has long been China's test subject. As reported by TFI in late April, reports had emerged that a major Chinese pharmaceutical company had invited the National Institute of Health, NIH, in Islamabad, the capital city of Pakistan, to collaborate in conducting the clinical trials of its recently developed inactivated vaccine for COVID-19 in Pakistan. The memorandum of understanding sent by the Chinese company to Pakistan had clearly stated that the vaccine had not been developed yet and that these were merely clinical trials. But some frivolous Pakistani media channels assumed that the benevolent Chinese masters had developed a magic COVID-19 vaccine and that Pakistan was one of the first beneficiaries to be administered the doses. The world has woken up to the threat of biowarfare, and if China's misadventures are nipped in the bud now, then the world might just be waiting for more pandemics to unfold.